What's up everyone, welcome back to another edition of DIY Box, where the best Android box is the one you build yourself. Today I return to my Khadas Edge2 project with the installation of the ARM Mini PC DIY case, converting this super powerful SBC board into an attractive elegant mini computer interface with full access to all of its ports, buttons and cooling features. So don't go anywhere, that's up next. So let's get started. For those of us who purchased the Khadas Edge2 Maker Kit would have received the SBC board with a cooling fan and heatsink pre-installed, and all that was required to complete the unit was the attractive case that was high in demand at the time. On the 20th of March this year, a limited number of these cases were made available to customers who already purchased the Maker Kit and wanted to upgrade to the ARM Mini PC layout. That offer has since ended, and I'm unsure when it will be made available again. To begin this assembly, it comes with a pair of tiny square foam adhesives that go over the two LED indicators. These are to guide the light emitting from the LEDs through two plastic tubes leading to the top of the case. The next step is to secure a 3M adhesive pad over the cooling fan and heatsink. This pad seals the top of the heatsink and channels its airflow from the fan through the heatsink out to the side of the case where there are ventilation holes. Whether this is the best decision or not for optimal cooling, I believe, is debatable, as there is ample ventilation through this metal grill. And for a little more details, there are two screws you can remove to detach the grill for an open case configuration. However, that would just spoil its cool appearance. The next step is to secure the two antennas to the plastic bracket that will be covering the FPC headers. Once installed, you would no longer have access to these headers, as it's no longer in development board mode, but to be used as an ARM Mini PC. There is one adhesive and two very small clips to secure it to the PCB. Once you ensure that the antenna wires are secured on the inside of the bracket, you can then proceed to the two final steps. Please note, attaching the included antennas can pose a bit of a challenge, as the pins are a tighter fit than the ones that came with the Maker board, so you have to be extra careful when fastening as to not damage the connectors. Now, to insert the board into the top cover, this is done by aligning the three buttons on the edge of the board and sliding that end in first. Then, once the buttons are secured in the slots, you can then press the other end to secure it into place. The final step is to secure the bottom panel. If you purchased the Maker Kit, in order to secure the bottom panel, you have to remove the two upper screws of the cooling fan before you attach the cover, because those are to be used for the screws to secure the bottom panel. Once the panel is secured, you simply attach the two anti-skid rubber pads in their designated slots. So viewers, I've finally completed my DIY project of the Khadas Edge2 ARM Mini PC. As you can see, it looks amazing with its LED lights, metal grill for ventilation, and easy access to its I/O ports with the exception of the FPC headers. So the correct term for this is an ARM mini PC. However, on this channel, I've just completed the most powerful Android TV box to date, and it's just in time for Khadas' latest Android 12 firmware update with huge compatibility updates. So to see the awesome performance and compatibility of this unit when applied as a super powerful Android box, subscribe to my channel by hitting that subscribe button and ringing that notifications bell, because you don't want to miss that video. So stay tuned and see you in my next video.